Hey everybody, it's me, Janaea, and this is a quick nursing video. I don't know how quick this video is going to be, but I've been, people have been commenting me, asking about how I'm doing as far as nursing school and wishing me luck and everything. And I want to say, let me just first say thank you to everybody that's been patient with me and my videos on nursing, because I know like half of my subscribers watch my channel for my nursing videos and other half watch for like other miscellaneous reasons. One maybe it being my hair or my fitness videos. So I haven't made a nursing video in a while. And the reason why I haven't made a nursing video is because nothing really exciting has been going on to make a video about. There's nothing really exciting going on. Like I obviously would have been made a video right now. The only thing I can update you guys on is maybe like my grades and how my rank is going. I'm not even gonna lie to y'all. I'm not doing the best right now. I'm not doing as good as I feel that I can do. I know that I can be an A student. I've been an A student. I've always been a straight A student. But at this point in my life, I feel like I have so much going on where I can't focus 100% the way that I want to focus on my schoolwork. One mainly being that now that I moved and I have to work to support myself, I can't spend as much time as I want studying when I have to work. And then I have, drama going on at work too. So it's like I have a lot going on. And with YouTube too, it's like I want to make videos for you guys, but it's really hard when you have, when you have a lot of stress, like stress going on in your life. But, I mean, that's another story. So recently, I started another class. I started my I can never say this right. I think I have, like, a speech problem. I started my pharmacology class 2 weeks ago. And let me say, the math part of it is not hard at all. But the memorization of the abbreviations that you have to know for this nursing course is like killing me. Like, I had an exam today and I was busting the questions out, getting them wrong, but as soon as I flipped the page and I saw that it was like numbers 1 through 50, you have to tell what each abbreviation means. Out of those 50 abbreviations that I had to know, I probably knew like 12. Like, I was so angry at myself that I didn't know those abbreviations. And it's like, the name of the class is Math for Pharmacology. So I'm thinking, like, I only have to know the math part. Mainly, I mean, and the teacher didn't even go into depth of what was going to be on the exam anyway. It's 75% of this class is online. So it's basically like, here's the chapters that the exam is going to be on. And you study the chapters. And you figure out what you need to know for this class. There's not much direction at all. So now that I know that I have to know all these abbreviations, I'm going to sit down and memorize them. And when I say, like, the 1 through 50 that was on this test, that's not all. It's like 3 pages worth of abbreviations. 3 pages. You want me to learn 6 chapters worth of work and 3 pages worth of abbreviations in a week and a half for an exam. And then on top of that, I have a nursing, I have two other nursing classes. I have attack nursing classes, basically the clinical part of the nursing class. And then I have my lecture part of the nursing class. And on top of that, I have another psychology class that I have to study for also. This class is crazy. I mean, the math, like I said, is not hard, but the memorization of all those abbreviations that you have to know, because not only is it math, but you also have to know a little bit about medications too, and how to read medication labels. So this is why you have to know the abbreviations. But it's hard. And I don't have the best memory on this planet, so it's really hard for me to learn all of that. But all I can say is I had my exam today, and when I left I was angry. Not angry at the teacher, because it's not the teacher's fault that I don't know it. I was angry at myself because I feel like I could have studied harder. But now that I know that I have to know that, then next time, I know what I have to do. I know how to memorize now. So next time, hopefully, I won't have to worry about that. But I'll show you guys a book. This is the book that I'm using for my pharmacology class. And like I said, it's pretty easy. You have to, it teaches you dosages and you have to read medicine labels. Pretty, I feel like, regular nursing stuff. Nothing too exciting to tell you guys. There's nothing exciting at all. As far as my lecture goes, nothing really exciting going on. Still just a regular lecture class. As far as notes, advice that I can give people with notes that are starting nursing school, if your class provides you with PowerPoint that goes along with their, that goes along with their lecture, please forgive me for the way that I'm talking. Like I said, I think I have a speech problem. I like trip over my words all the time as I talk. But take advantage of your PowerPoint. I went, got my PowerPoints bound in a book so I can carry this around with me so I don't lose any of them. Because I know how I am. I lose stuff. I'm a normal person. I lose stuff. Like I said, I got a lot of stuff going on in my life. Take advantage of your notes. Take advantage of the notes that your professor gives you. Whether it be nursing, a nursing program, an LPN program, a CNA program. If your professor is giving you some notes, which most professors don't do, take advantage of your notes. If they tell you to go and read something, go read it. Like, they're not telling you for their health. They're telling you to read it for a reason. So if they tell you to read pages 100 through 275, then read pages 100 through 275. They tell you to read it for a reason. There's information in there that you need to know. I also got a question from someone that's in an LPN program about any advice that I would give her. I don't really know much about an LPN program because I'm not in an LPN program. I'm in an RN program. I don't really know the difference between the two. But all I can say is, I mean, I'm not done with my program yet, so I can't give you that much advice. But all I can say is stick with it. Be positive. Study. Like I said, if your professor is providing you notes or providing you with any type of extra help, take advantage of it. Even if you feel like you're doing the, you know, even if you feel like you're at the top of the class and you get the best grades that you can, take advantage of it. I mean, they're there for a reason. I mean, unless you walking around with you valedictorian, you get 100% on everything, then cool, you know, do your thing. But if you ain't getting 100%, you only getting 95s, you can take advantage of it and you could get that 100, you know? Take advantage of the resources that are being offered to you. Study, I think I said be optimistic. Study, be optimistic. Stay positive. It's going to be hard. Nothing that's worth working for is going to be easy. And being a nurse is a serious job. Like, being a nurse is not... And that's one thing I can say about some people that I see that are on YouTube. I'm not going to name anybody or point anyone out, but not even on people that are on YouTube or that just regularly say, oh, I want to be an RN. Being an RN is more, it's more than just the money. Is more than just the aspect of, oh, I get to walk around in nice scrubs, or I get to work in a hospital and wear stethoscope around my neck. Y'all are worried about the stigma of the job and how it looks. Being a nurse, when you become a nurse, it's, that becomes your your lifestyle. That becomes a title. That becomes you. Just like when you were born and you, someone gave you your name, like when I was born and my mother named me Janaea. I'm Janaea. When you graduate as a nurse, you pass your NCLEX and you become an RN. You're an RN. That's who you are. That's your lifestyle. Being an RN, that's you. It's not just a job. And I feel like to be a successful RN, that's how you have to feel about the job. Like, to you, it's not a job. This is, like, what you were meant to do. No, it's raining outside. Great. That's why my hair looks like this, because it's raining. But if you're becoming a nurse or LPN or a CNA, those people that you're going to take care of are going to count on you to treat them like human beings. And you can't just treat this like a job. You're there to help someone. You're there to help someone. Whether you're there to help someone get better or help someone, you know, move on to the... You know what I mean by move on. You're there to help someone, you know, die comfortably. Whatever you're there for, you know, you got to be the best at it. Because I know if I had a family member in a hospital, I wouldn't want them to have a crazy, a terrible nurse. I want someone that knows their stuff. So if you're in any type of medical field, medical program, take it seriously, because, you know, these are people's lives that you're holding in your hands. And I know I'm sitting up here, you know, you could say, oh, you're not an RN yet, you don't know nothing. You're right, I'm not an RN yet, and I don't know everything that I can know, but I do know that I want to be an RN. I do know that I want to be as good as I can at it. I want to be great at it. You know, I even will go as far as to say I want to be the best at it, because it's something serious, you know? Like I said, these are people's lives that you're, you know, dealing with. So you have to take that seriously. But let me get out of that seriousness. As far as nursing school goes, you know, I'm sticking with it. I still love it. I still want to do what I want to do. Something to look forward in the future. I know next semester I start on, I can never get this word right, geriatrics, I think it's called. I'm going to start with geriatrics. That's basically working with the older people, like in the hospice or the nursing homes. So that's what I can look forward to next semester. I should be getting, I still don't wear the school's scrubs yet. I don't wear their, you know, scrubs with the logo on it. But as soon as I do get it, I should be getting mine in May. As soon as I get it, I will show you guys what it looks like and all of that jazz. To be honest, I don't remember what I just talked about in this video. And I know this video was like real put together. I'm trying to wrap this video up now because it is like, it's like a tsunami outside right now where I live. It's like thundering and lightning. But if anybody has any questions, feel free to leave them down below or email me. The one young lady that emailed me, I never got a chance to reply back because I knew I was going to make a video as far as that goes. But I'll probably reply back to her anyway tonight. But like I said, I've been busy. I have a little more free time on my hands. But any questions or comments, anyone that wants to leave, just leave it down below. And I think that's it. And I will wish luck to all the other nursing students that are watching me. If you are a nursing student and you do have a YouTube channel, comment down below, because I would love to watch everyone else's videos. I love to watch nursing videos. So comment down below, or, you know, whatever. But until next video, I'll talk to you guys later. Bye.